Okay. So now we have nothing really to discuss, I just wanted to play UI. But let me show you how easy it is to improvise in Linux and create topics out of anything. So we start by opening a web browser, and search for a somewhat popular project. For example, let's go to elementary GitHub, but I could have gone anywhere really. I think here I will go for Gala perhaps. And because whatever is on master is already old and boring, I will search on pull requests. And boom! Make full screen to new workspace is optional, on the top of the list. I didn't even need to scroll down. And that wasn't a setup, that's how things exactly happen in reality. So, this specific feature is one of the most annoying things in elementary, and especially on earlier releases it was extremely buggy too, to a point of actually wondering how it was even possible to implement something so terrible. Now it plays much smoother, but it is still annoying, so I really hope to make it optional. Anyway, time to go on actual demo and I will typically start from GNOME. So I'm opening a terminal, and next I'm opening a file manager. Now if we go to terminal and press F11 to full screen it, we can just alt tab and bring the file manager on the top of a full screen window. And all the action takes place on a single workspace. In the meantime, I'm running elementary and Mac OS on Quick Emulator, I'm working this video on Olive Editor, and at the same time I'm screencasting too, on an Intel i5. I'm telling you, Fedora has gone to a whole new level. And I'm promising you, you simply can't do that on Ubuntu. Back to the original topic, having floating windows over full screens has unlimited and obvious user cases, so I'm not going to waste time explaining that, and instead I will jump directly to elementary. And I will simply repeat the process. So I'm opening a terminal and then a file manager. Now if I go on terminal and press F11 to full screen it, the terminal will automatically create a new workspace on the right, and it will move there. So in this care we'll end up with two workspaces. One for the terminal and one for the file manager. But now we can take the file manager, and throw it to the terminal workspace. So we still can have floating windows over full screens, and that makes even more meaningful to have an option on settings to customize this feature, as that pull request was proposing. Opening full screens always to a new workspace has some advantages too, but in practice and on desktop at least, most of the times doesn't work that good. Very often people compare this elementary feature with Mac OS, but in reality there is nothing alike. For start, in Mac OS we don't have dynamic workspaces, and that completely changes the workflow in that specific feature. Okay, I repeat the same as previously, by opening a terminal and a file manager. And something more to notice, is that the green button fullscreens the window by default, rather maximizing it. Full screen windows in Mac OS will open on a special workspace, that actually gets the name of the running apps. And if we go on file manager and move it to the terminal, Mac OS will actually ask us for tiling it, and the workspaces will be renamed to the both apps. And everything inside will be full screen, which is a very smart approach honestly. Another conceptual difference, is that we can't actually close this workspace, but only on full screen the apps. I could extend a whole lot more in this video, but unfortunately I ran out of song. こんなシチュエーション、漫画で見たことあります。